Hi guys, so are you ready for some case porn? You know, one of these days I'm going to get arrested with case porn and Murdoch's organs. Yeah, anyway, if I appear to be stuttering my speech and concentrating too much at the camera, it's because I'm looking at the audio bar for any signs of noise. Now, I tried to take the previous microphone to pieces and put it in a plastic case as a means of getting rid of some of the ground hiss, noise, interference, whatever. I failed. So this is another one of the same type of microphone which I've rewired for stereo, and we're just going to have to see how it goes, I guess. Now, many people will say, I look at the screens, I use the keyboard, I use the mouse. I don't even look at the case. The only time I look at the case is when I put a CD in a rote. Let's face it, in some cases, people don't even know that the box is the computer. They think it's the screen. But there you go. Until you show people the kinds of cases that various autistic people are creating, boom! I'm not autistic, unfortunately. So, or fortunately, depending on your point of view. But there you go. Let's have a digestive and some cup of some tea. So, cases. In my case, I do appreciate a good-looking case, don't get me wrong. However, I prefer function over form in many cases. Cases! Haha! See what I did there? Forget it. So a number of my cases over the years have been practical. The first ones that I really loved aesthetically were the Thermaltake Zaser 3 cases. Legends in their own right. I had four of them at one point, and they came here with me. Back in those days, we were generating an awful lot of heat for the power PCs, and those cases came with like seven supposedly ultra-silent fans, which was a big bonus. When I came here, however, 8 or so years ago, three of the Zasers were behind me. They were quite tall beasts, and one was in there. In winter, it was fine. They warmed the room up a treat, but in summer it was real, real serious grief. It was so bad that I was actually contemplating installing an air conditioning unit outside the building. Yeah, that bad. So, that's culminated with a few other things to try and go to low power computing, which also succeeded and failed on a number of occasions. What can I say? The net result is some of what you have behind me here. Now, this is the HP server with a Nokia router in front of it. There's another one down here, and this gap is where the where is it? It's this one. What's the name of it? Fractal. That's where the Fractal case normally lives, and it's got a machine in it, and it's normally wired up. But the cases, I decided to go over to ITX, basically. And I tried to go small, but still try and keep some power. The Fit PC3 was one of the more notable failures. It worked for a while, but the problem, as I've said before, with a lot of this computing is when you need that little bit extra, you haven't got it. And yeah, sometimes you can be waiting ages, and eventually, the Fit PC3, no fans, eventually I think something got heat damaged in there. But there you go. So the cases have varied. One of the things that I determined was, in order to reduce the heat, was rather to not generate it. And I went over to some of the Pico PSUs, and they, among other things, were running on external transformers. The external transformers being switch mode power supplies, and eventually they gave up. Some of them have lasted longer than others, Some have lasted about 3 years and they're still rocking. About half of them failed in about the first year. Not good. This is one cool case, Sedatec, I think. You can see the size of this against my hand. It's quite small for packing a decent machine. The ITX motherboard format is itself quite small, and these days there's so much on these motherboards. This one is a good 3 or 4 years old. And take a look at the back of that. I mean, you've got VGA, DVI, HDMI. You've got, I think that's either 5.1 surround or 7.1. It's gigabit networking. On top of optical audio if you want it. And as you can see, there's the input for the externally transformed 12-volt power. And in this case, it was the external power supply that that gave up the ghost. And, you know, you don't really need anything much. The processor itself isn't actually all that powerful. You can see the fan in there. That's the only fan that it relies on. And, it's pretty cool. On top of that, the case has a number of other bits and pieces up its sleeve. If I open this, you can see that you've got another two USB sockets and you've got your headphones and microphone. And on the other side, which is pretty cool, because you haven't got any space here for an optical drive, obviously. You also haven't got any space in here for a graphics card. You're stuck with whatever's on board. But for some people, that's cool. And this was great for me. You can see an external Molex connector and an eSATA connector. So you can actually hook up an external eSATA device, be it CD-ROM or hard drive, at your will. This was before the days of USB 3, I think. Yeah, because all these are USB 2 at the back. But there is another eSATA port on the back, and there's like six USBs on the back, you know. So things like these are definitely around, and they are a bit more powerful than, pardon me, some of the low power stuff you can get. I had to use some black tape at the front because the LED was just too darn powerful, and there's just a power switch. I think one section of LED is actually drive activity. Can't remember because this has been out of action for a while. The machine still works. I may have reused the RAM in something else. I don't know. Have I? There's a step down in there. There's a little space for a laptop hard drive. And no, there is some RAM in there, but not much. So that's the kind of thing that's around. ITX is pretty much where I stayed. And another reason why I stayed at it, that was because I was trying to cut down on, I was still on ATX motherboards before I finally made the decision. And this was one of the attempts at a more compact ATX case. Now, this is one of the cooler masters, and you can be forgiven for thinking that this can actually handle three optical drives. It can't, it can only handle one. Behind the other two is actually space for a power supply. That's because when you look at the back, the height of this is the issue, because when you look at the back, you can see that the entire width of this is given up to the motherboard, and also the expansion slots for a full ATX motherboard. The power supply input, which is here, actually goes via a cable inside. And the power supply, if I can show you in here, get rid of that. I can roughly show you what's going on in here. One of the reasons why I abandoned this case was because the optical drives were vertical. Or the optical drive singular was vertical. And in the future, I will pretty much always go with a horizontal. As you can see, inside, big space for the motherboard. And you can see in the back there, you can see the large gap down around here for the power supply, and then you've got the optical drive bay here. There you've got a hard disk bay, and that's pretty much about it. But for a full-sized ATX motherboard, this is about as far as you're going to get. Again, basic cases, because I wasn't forking out too much money on these. I've got these cases because I was... I've been reworking my needs all the time and reevaluating things and coming to various decisions. To get the smaller cases, you basically need to go ITX, and the onboard functions are now just incredible, to be perfectly honest. They're very powerful pieces of kit in their own right. Is that in right? I'm not 100% sure. I'll sort that out later. But as you can see, these are very, very basic cases. There's no flair to them, and there's certainly no opportunity for anything like LEDs or that sort of thing. Maybe they're out of the sides or the rest of that jazz. They are very cheap cases because I wasn't bothered about flashy LEDs. Pretty much my needs are being reevaluated all the time. I'm starting to actually shut down machines, and I'm now basically just running five. One is the file server, and you've got the two client machines over there for the power using. One is the Minecraft server, and off to there you have the web server and Lineage 2. Now at some point the Lineage 2 Java game will cease, at which point I don't need a full PC just to do web work. A Pi drive is in the post, and there's been quite a high order for them, so there's been a delay of about 3 to 4 weeks, and then once the Lineage 2 Java game is finished, that's going to be another machine that bites the dust. Pretty much it will then be replaced by the Pi for web work, which will occupy less space, less power, because I won't need the processor cycles. I'm really interesting to see how, over the next couple of years, what will happen with the Pi. I'm really hoping that it ups the power a bit and ups the RAM a touch. Microsoft is also on board with the Windows 10 image for the Pi. And they're obviously focused on the Pi for a lot of the Internet of Things stuff. You know, the small things. Ultimately, I think that once they've got everything ported, I think the ARM chips will become a serious contender for the average office desktop. Not for the power user, but I think the average desktop user in an office will likely be using ARMs in a few years. I mean, with Windows 10 ported over and all the rest of it, yeah, I think it'll happen. The other beauty about using thin clients and web services is that the majority of the stuff is running on the servers anyway. What architecture you're running on your client, who cares? Now, this following case is a Silverstone. I do like it. It has the one problem in that there is no optical drive. I started off by not particularly being concerned about that, but I did need at that point to come off the external transformers, and this was an ideal way to do it. These sort of things are again billed as builders media PCs, cases for your living room. And again, it's ITX format. You can see at the back that you have the ITX motherboard. You also have a few side sockets if your motherboard can take, and if you want to put in an extra graphics card, you've got the space to do it. And the big difference in this one is that you can see the hole for the standard power supply. And indeed, it relies on the power supply to throw air up and out for the majority of the airflow. You probably can't see it in here because the fan is black. In fact, you can. It's right around there. That's the processor fan, and typically that's about it. And these ITX motherboards are quite low power, and there's no RAM in here. I've already reused it by the looks. Looking in at the back, I looked and saw the the way that things are put together in here, there's no easy way to get a CD-ROM drive in here. No easy way at all, because of the way that the metal in the front of the case is worked. So, although I would have loved to get one of those, it was a case of, if I got another one of these, with a front CD DVD drive case, it would cost a fair chunk of cash on top of that. And there was another reason why I didn't want to do it. When I was looking for alternatives to these with exactly the features that I wanted, or as close as I could get, wasn't easy. The amount of money was getting was around the same sort of price as the Stackers. I think I found them on offer at some point. So I eventually just bit the bullet and went with the Stacker, because I knew that the A10 processor needed more room and more space for the processor than this could offer. The power supply is just too close to the top of the motherboard to really get anything effective in there. It could be done, but the other thing is that the hard drive is mounted sideways in here, and there isn't exactly any easy hole space in order to mount another fan. So you're stuck with whatever the power supply does. So on that score, this case failed. I needed another case. But I'm going to keep that around because it's a nice design. I like the way it goes together, and there will probably be a time when I will need this format. So among the cases that are going to get thrown away, that is not one of them. That is one I'm going to hang on to. Even the front ports are USB 3. Now, this is the Fractal case. Of all the cases which I can possibly get LEDs in and make look really cool, this is the one. Ultimately, when it comes time to upgrade the Minecraft server, this is the case that the server will go into, and it will live underneath the HP, under there. It's got a nice sort of grid front to it, and it's got a nice clean look to it. The controls are actually on the side for this, which isn't too much. I mean, it's not too much of a bother to me. The power switch is around there, because when it's running as a server, that's pretty much it. That's all it's got to do. This is currently got an ATX motherboard in it. It's a bit on the old side. An ITX will go in there relatively easily, I think. It's got my last Tegan power supply in it. And yeah, it's pretty much a nice case, and I've got options with it. I mean, I can see through a chunk of this. I should be able to put in some quite funky LEDs behind there and have them gently shining out. I don't like LEDs which are too strong. So, yeah. The other problem is that this one, Fractal, which is Fractal design, it doesn't give me a model number on here as to which one this is, but it's not exactly the newest case around. It's got another external fan mount there, one at the back, and this is going to be pretty good. If it came to it, another A10 processor in here on another motherboard would be absolutely beautiful, with another cooler water cool fan unit, because these are nice and quiet, which will then kill some of the sound that's coming out of these two. And you'll see the cases when I come to do the server porn, and they're not very much. They're just bog standard PCs in pretty much the cheapest functional cases that I could get at the time. In fact, one of those I think is still running on a Pico PSU, which is interesting. The Fractal case actually came with this, which is this shows you how old it is. It came with this, which is an optional front panel for a floppy drive. That's how old it is. But I do like the design. So pretty much most of my cases have been cheap cases for the function and cost. You know, when they're stuck in the middle of nowhere, there's nothing. But I'm going to reclaim a chunk of that space back. Can you actually see them? If I move my hand, no, you can see this one here, but you can't see that one there. You may be able to, I can't see everything on the camera, but they're basically bog standard cheap PC cases. So the net result is that if a case looks nice, okay, that's cool. If it's got a good aesthetic to it, yeah, bonus. But I think these days I'm going for ITX cases, and I'm tricking them out pretty much just like the machines that are in there that you saw in the build from hell. I think that's where I'm going with a lot of this stuff. The noisiest machines by far are these, and they are by far the noisiest because they are pretty much the cheapest. Didn't exactly put a lot of money behind them. So yeah, I went through trying to make things smaller, and I hit points where you've got to ditch the ATX format and go to ITX in order to make any significant gains, but you can't go too far because you've still got to fit a decent power supply in there and have enough room for cooling. Now, the stacker units are actually quite long, and even those have got flaws. I have not yet managed to find the perfect case. yeah, I think I've spoken about those cases in a previous, that CD drawers, the optical CD drawers, are directly underneath the USB and headphone cables. So when you eject the drawer, you've got the cables to battle with. Not the best, to put it mildly. But yeah, I think that's about it for the case porn. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what happens when the Pi drive comes, how that works, and I want to get it up and running as a web server. I don't think that things are over yet. What you're looking at here is about 8 years worth of case changes as I've gone and investigated different bits and pieces. So things continue to change. I really do hope that the stackers, because they are ITX, their format, I think that they will last. So long as I can overcome the cable issue, the cable overhang issue, I think those will be with me for many years to come, just like the Zeta 3s were. if you've got any specific comments about the choices that I've made and the various things over the years, yeah, drop me a note. Definitely the Fractal case is being kept. That's going to be the Minecraft server in the future. The silver stone case is going to be kept, because I think that in the future there will be an ARM chip on an ITX board, and this would make the ideal case for it, because when I get that, then I won't require the optical drive for that. The other two, one has still got a computer in it, a working machine, and I'm not sure what I want to do yet. And that's the trick. As the years go on, the needs and requirements keep changing, and that means the computers that I'm running keep changing, and what I'm using the machines for also keeps changing. I think that I've now learned the lesson in not making snap judgments and not getting rid of kit unless I really want to get rid of it, unless there's a really solid reason to throw stuff away. What I've got to do is work on repurposing what I've already got as opposed to buying new, and getting it right when I do. It's a lesson that's taken me many, many years to learn, and I'm still making mistakes now, but what can I say? I think that's about it. That's roughly some of the cases that I've been through, the decisions that I've made, and yeah, I think that ITX motherboards, ITX cases, decent power supplies are the way to go. The only thing that upsets it is whether or not you think that you need an optical drive. and exactly how much power you put behind the processor as to how much cooling you need. And whether your case looks reasonably stylish, I can just make do with a nice, stylish, decent, artistic look to it. I don't need loads of flashing LEDs and all the rest of that jazz, because at the end of the day, I don't look at it that much. There are some really, really nice artistic cases out there. I am not artistic myself, so I can't really do that sort of stuff. But, yeah, I know my limits. So I hope you've enjoyed taking a look at some of these cases. At some point I want to go through the Stacker series in a little bit more detail and give you a few more close-ups when I get the time to actually film in a mode where I can edit stuff together rather than doing an entire piece to camera. So I'm going to finish my tea and biggies, and I'll catch you on the next video. Bye for now.